What a wonderful poem, a song of life written by famed New England poet and professor Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. What the heart of the young man said to the psalmist: "Tell me not, in mournful numbers, life is but an empty dream, for the soul is dead that slumbers, and things are not what they seem. Life is real, life is earnest, and the grave is not its goal. Dust thou art, to dust returnest," was not spoken of the soul. "Not enjoyment and not sorrow is our destined end or way, but to act that each tomorrow find us farther than today. Hour is long and time is fleeting, and our hearts, though stout and brave, still like muffled drums are beating funeral marches to the grave. In the world's broad field of battle, in the byway of life, be not like a dumb driven cattle, be a hero in the strife. Trust no future however pleasant, let the dead past bury its dead. Act in the living present, heart within and God overhead. Life's a great men all remind us, we can make our life sublime, and departing leave behind us footprints on the sands of time. Footprints that perhaps another, sailing over life's solemn main, a forlorn and shipwrecked brother, seeing shall take heart again. Let us then be up and doing with a heart for any fate, still achieving and still pursuing, learn to love and wait." Now let us analyze the deeper meaning of the poem. First, the speaker begs the psalmist not to sing to him in numerous sorrowful ways about how life is empty and unreal. In the speaker's opinion, the soul that passionately experiences life is essentially dead. Moreover, one shouldn't assume that life is merely how it seems from a certain perspective, that it is just a precursor to eternal life after death. Life, the speaker demands, is very much real and full of meaning. Life, the speaker asks, is sincere and intense. The meaning of life is not simply death. The Christian saying of dust to dust, which states that humans come from the earth and return to dust upon death, only refers to the body and not the soul. So the soul should be full of life. It's not indulgence or misery that should be humanity's destiny or goal. Rather, the speaker declares humans should act in such a manner that creates progress day by day. Acts and products of human creativity last a long time, however time passes quickly. While human hearts may be strong and courageous, nevertheless, they beat like quiet drums within bodies. Ultimately, with each beat, they bring humans closer to their death. Therefore, the songs these hearts produce are like funeral marches. The speaker then compares the world to a great battlefield. Life, he adds, is like a temporary camp without shelter. Therefore, the speaker commands, don't be like silent cattle who are herded about. Rather, be a hero amidst the conflict of life. Don't place any certainty. The speaker advises, in the future, no matter how positive the future may seem. Additionally, don't dwell on the past. Rather, the speaker suggests one should live in the present wholeheartedly and in plain view of God, who watches approvingly above in heaven. The way that great men that lived their lives inspires and reminds other individuals to consciously live in a godly and spiritual manner. Moreover, the speaker adds, when these individuals die, they will leave traces of their lives behind. These remnants and memories of godly and spiritual lives can go on to inspire us, who might also be progressing over the great ocean of life. These other individuals might feel miserable, abandoned and lost in this ocean. However, upon seeing examples of godly and spiritual lives, they will be inspired and saved. Therefore, all humanity, the speaker advises, should seize the day. Moreover, they must live life wholeheartedly and fearlessly. While making progress and seeking improvement, humans will learn to struggle and apply themselves as well as have patience.